Jesus promised to reveal himself to us, and he will actually confirm to us when he's pleased with us, because he's looking forward to use us and to develop a real relationship with us. There is much work, but the laborers are few. And this is because most people don't have time for God. They occupy their time with their hobbies and pleasures and lusts, and this hinders them to develop a relationship with God. Jesus is looking for disciples who seek his kingdom first and his righteousness. Let's face the truth, friends. We all know the truth deep down. God cannot be mocked. We can't be born again. But if we carnal, if we live in the flesh, then as it's written in Galatians chapter 5, those who live like that will not inherit the kingdom of God. How can God use us if we live in the flesh? How can God rely on us if we don't have control over our selfish ambitions? How can God send us if we live in immorality, and fornication, drunkenness, hatred, outbursts of wrath? How can we hear the guidance of the Holy Spirit if we live in the flesh? The flesh lusts against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. These are contrary to one another. Galatians chapter 5. With God there is no partiality. He loves us all the same. But he will use those who make themselves available. Those who crucify the flesh with his lusts and desires, and worship him in spirit and in truth. The main reason why God is not using most Christians is because even if they are born again of water and the Spirit, they never became disciples of Jesus Christ. They never matured in Christ. They still babes in Christ. I will share a personal testimony, but I want to mention that it's not about me. It's about Jesus Christ and what he did for me and what he can do for you. In the summer of 2019, one morning I woke up and I heard the voice of the Lord in my spirit that said, "Today you become a man." I want to share with you what I was about to do that morning and what happened a few weeks prior. But first I want to tell you that I became a disciple of Jesus Christ in 2018. And I was born again of water and the Spirit, and the Lord gave me much revelation through dreams and visions, and also I heard the voice of the Lord speaking to me clearly. However, it wasn't until that morning that I became a mature person in the eyes of the Lord. In the summer of 2019, I had noticed some bank fraud on my bank account, so I went to the bank and they told me I have to go to the police station and report this. In the end, everything was sorted and I got my money back. But at the police station, they told me they can see in the system that I'm needed at the court for some reason. They couldn't tell me why, but they said it's a good idea to go and check it out. So I went to the court and they told me that a person had reported me 5 years prior regarding an incident that happened. And I immediately knew what the incident was about. And I'm not gonna get into details, but they explained to me if I was gonna come 2 months later, the case would be erased because it was just too long time after the incident. But I came, so they have to proceed with things. So they gave me a lawyer, a lady about the same age as me, and she told me that if I deny the accusations, then they don't have any proof, so everything will be fine. However, I said to her that I'm a disciple of Jesus Christ and a Christian, so I say the truth. I cannot deny the accusations. She tried to convince me. She said, you know, it's not saying lies, you just deny the accusations and things like that. But I didn't agree to that, you know. Denying accusations is like denying the truth. It's like, it's the same like lying. So I didn't agree with that. And she started explaining to me, if I'm gonna say the truth, I'm gonna have to face the probability of going to jail, and I'm gonna have to pay some compensation to this person because there are no self-defense laws in Spain. I just said that I will say the truth regardless of the circumstances or repercussions. A few weeks after, I woke up that morning and the Lord spoke to me in my spirit and He said, today you become a man. And I want to tell you that the thing that I'm most happy about is that I didn't have second thoughts that day. I just couldn't wait to go to court and to say the truth to the judge and to everybody there. And it's what I did that day. I went there and I said the truth. Because I said the truth, they didn't send me to jail. I paid some compensation to that person and I also had to pay another fine. Actually, last month was the last month of the installments that I was supposed to pay. But glory to Jesus Christ, because He changed me and He helped me to become a better person and to be responsible of my own actions, even if they were before I became a disciple of Jesus Christ. So this is why this is not about me. This is about Jesus Christ and what He did for me and what He can do for you. This is to give glory to Jesus Christ, my Lord and Master, and to tell you that He's looking forward to use you in a mighty way. Jesus knows everything about you. He knows your hidden talents that you have and never knew about. But you have to start to prove that you believe in Him and trust His words and love Him with all your heart. Put your trust in God. Not in me, not in any other human being. Put your focus on the Spirit of Christ and let nothing distract you. Seek Him day and night with all your heart, and He will reveal Himself to you and use you for His kingdom and for His glory. My Jesus bless you.